What's up, people? That's right, I'm back. Couldn't leave out stage 3, could I? Just like previously, we're gonna start out with our skirmish leading up to stage 3. It's always good to start it out with a good old sneak attack if you can find somebody that's lagging behind. Like I said last time, we have a much better chance at ending the game at stage 2. But it doesn't always happen that way. Very rarely did I ever get to stage 3 in the alpha. And that's not because I got hunted down, that's because I ended the game before then, with a win. Now if you remember from last time, we're going into this stage 2 fight being on the verge of evolving to stage 3. This particular fight does not go very well for me. You can see I've already taken a small bit of health damage from the first fight, and my shields are already down. If you find yourself in this situation and the arena is still up, you need to run and take cover until it goes down. The more health you have going into stage 3, the more use you can get out of your maximum damage. Here I was in the heat of the moment, but I finally start to realize just how much trouble I'm in. So I retreat until the bubble goes down, and I evolve into stage 3. Alright guys, this is the moment we've been waiting for. Beast mode engage. Now, as soon as you evolve to stage 3, you want to keep in mind that the hunters are going to make a break for the relay in order to defend. This is a very predictable tactic, and we can take advantage of it in several ways. One of the beautiful things about evolving to stage 3 is that they'll never know how close you are to hitting stage 3. One strategy you can employ is, before you evolve to stage 3, run all the way out to the edge of the map, as far from the relay as you could possibly get. Get the hunters to follow you, and then try to race them back to the relay and destroy the relay before they can return. This was the first tactic I developed while playing the monster, while the most uninteresting. Also, it's very risky because if you get trapped and have to fight, then you have no shields because you didn't have time to feed. Another strategy I mentioned in my previous video is to fight near the relay as stage 2, and kill 2 of them, at least, and if the other 2 scramble and have cloak, well, you can just go to stage 3 and force the fight at the relay. Unfortunately, it doesn't always go that well. So you're going to find yourself in this situation, where all 4 hunters are alive and well, and they're all defending the relay. They have mines, they have traps, they have everything set up ready for you. Something you just saw me do was throw a rock into the mines they had set up there. That's right, rock throw destroys mines and traps. That's why I pick it up every single time. This is going to be quite the uphill battle for the hunters at this point, especially if you have almost full health. When you manage to down your first hunter, you need to leave them alive as long as possible. Do not go for the kill. If you kill them, you will have gotten rid of your bait. But something most people don't think about is the death timer. The longer you leave that player to bleed out on the ground, the more time you have to do damage to the rest of the team before the countdown begins. Luckily, this is one of the easier fighting grounds near the power relay. Generally, these fighting grounds are more advantageous for the hunters, and rightfully so. They will hide behind obstructions and on top of small objects, and you need to be prepared for this. Do not panic, keep your cool, and remember your priorities. If while you're going on your rampage, some players begin to run away from the power relay, just begin hitting the relay in order to force the fight. Just remember, time is of the essence. Also, it's good to note that it takes about 30 seconds to take down the power relay. Watch the clock. You always need to be doing something during the fight, whether it's beating down a hunter, or their poor little dog, or going after the relay. And remember, if things are going bad for you and you have the chance to escape with most of your health, you can do that. Replenish your shield and come back again for another fight. Just remember that the game has a time limit. And that will show up in the top left along with the hunter's time limit. This game's coming to a close. We're gonna check out the next one here in a minute. Alright, here we go. Game 2. You saw it here first, people. The monster can enter the arena from the outside. Pro tip. Going into these fights, I like to go all in. Having about 3/4 of your health left is a good thing. If you've been doing your job knocking down the hunters, this is going to be an easier fight for you. Much, much easier. Before entering the fight, however, I always like to look for a buff before I enter the fight. Only do this provided you have enough time. You want to take every little advantage you can get, increasing your chances of winning in the end. Another little tip that I learned recently, if you find yourself in a game with Lazarus, you're going to want to make him priority number one. But if you happen to kill one of his teammates before him, eat them if you can. That's right, you can eat dead hunters. This will prevent Lazarus from reviving them, and it'll also give you a nice little boost to your shield. Although I believe if you are getting shot, then you cannot eat. So keep that in mind. Another combat tip for you guys. If you're just sitting there auto-attacking, aka just doing regular attacks, and the person you are attacking is getting low on health, try canceling your attack into a charge. That'll give a lot of burst damage, and will ensure that you get the player down. What I mean by canceling is, as soon as you punch a player and you see the damage go onto them, hit your charge and that will cancel the rest of your attacking animation into some nice burst damage. Another good thing to note is that while you're attacking the relay, players that are shooting you with your pistols will not be able to stop you from destroying it. Well guys, this is the end for now. The alpha's over and I'm out of gameplay footage. Hoping to see you guys on release. And hopefully you guys can look at these tips and get a little head start when the game comes out. Thanks for watching, and subscribe for more gaming content.